Well, good afternoon. Thank you very much to the organizing committee, especially to YQ for the invitation. So we have heard a lot of great talks about plants, and would that be really great to educate more people in liberal arts colleges, inviting them into the plant world? And so I joined Hope College 8 years ago and got involved in different kinds of courses, including introductory biology, plant systematics, evolutionary biology, and ethnobotany. And in the past 8 years, we have changed our introductory courses from 3 into 2. So during the process, of course, we reduced the number of the time, but we still kind of try to cover the major subjects, including cells and genetics, ecology and evolution, and organismal biology. And of course, that means we reduce the time to really focus on individual aspect, and especially plants. But it's equally cut, of course, in terms of timing, the time. But generally, you have less students enrolling in the upper level courses that are plant related or plant based. So in some ways, we have been kind of reducing the time spent on botanical education. So, of course, that really made me feel really concerned about botanical education in liberal arts colleges. So I kind of did some research online and also talked with some of the colleagues in other liberal arts colleges. And so this is what I want to share with you and the challenges and opportunities of botanical education in liberal arts colleges. And so of course, the most important thing is to really hear from you or see what you have to say about botanical education in liberal arts colleges or colleges overall, right? So, so after studying a little bit about this botanical education in universities, especially in liberal arts colleges, and it looks like there is this decrease in number of schools offering plant biology majors. And well, when that happens, of course, you expect to see a drop in the number of graduates as well. And this is the a figure showing, indeed, there is a decrease of number of schools offering plant biology majors. And also, of course, and this shows the decrease of number of students graduating from with a biology or botany major, plant biology major. Well, if you think about, that's the kind of overall pattern in the country. And then what about liberal arts colleges? And as far as I could find, these are only 2 colleges that actually have a botany major offered, exactly 2. Well, now, how about faculty members in liberal arts colleges? And what you see here in general, you actually have 1 or 2 faculty members and that in the biology programs that focus on plant sciences. And clearly that means that you don't have a good critical mass of colleagues that you can actually talk about plants, right? But of course, with the information era, and we can always communicate with our colleagues in other places, but that cannot replace critical mass, right? Well, for example, at Hope College, we have 3 faculty members that have been doing plant-related research, but only, I guess, 2/3 of them really, you know, don't consider themselves as plant biologists. Well, if you think about students in liberal arts colleges and what what's their interest getting into biology programs? So of course, large proportion of students are pre-health and pre-med, and which is a good thing. And if you look at the nationwide number, that's about 50%. But if you look at liberal arts colleges, and that's higher. And if you think, so I did some survey in Hope College in a general biology courses, and we have actually 75 to 80% of students that are pre-med. Right? Well, if they want to go to medical school or health-related schools, then what do they have to do, right? So they, of course, they have to do well in their courses, and then they have to go through exam. And in terms of the requirements from medical schools, of course, the requirements can vary. But in general, and that's the requirement. And a year of biology with lab, a year of general chemistry with lab, and a year of organic chemistry with lab, of course, and 1 year of physics, and 1 year English and calculus, or other college level math. And of course, not much botanical education that required. Of course, they want students to take, you know, some upper level courses to show they are indeed capable of, or potentially capable of, finishing medical school. And these are the ones here. So organismal diversity and general microbiology, genetics and cell biology, developmental biology, organic chemistry, biochemistry, human physiology. So of course, when you look at these courses, and not a whole lot of these courses include specifically botanical aspect. And you may say, well, there is probably some in the organismal biodiversity. Well, also, if you think about a lot of students getting into the pre-health area and also botany, and what's interesting is early on, before at the end of 1800s, and you see botany and medicine in being very closely tied, and indeed, people have actually considered this two, the botany as the beautiful handmaiden of medicine. And so indeed, a lot of people who wanted to go to the medical area, and they actually are very much interested in botany. And there are many examples. One of them is shown here, David Hossack. And so initially, he wanted to be a lawyer and then go into medicine and then switch to botany, to focus on botany. And of course, he's also a physician. And then he taught this course for many years. And interestingly, he attended Alexander Hamilton, who actually died after being shot by the rival here, who left. This rival actually was the vice president, Andrew Franklin. So, well, after that, and you see botany being developed into the scientific area, and then medicine being kind of separated, and pretty soon, actually, people started to complain about not having enough interest from students getting botanical education, right? Or that are interested in botany. Well, if you look at the courses taught in liberal arts colleges, and in general, you have some botanical education in general biology, right? Some have general botany, and others include some, you know, plant part in the introductory biology, which actually happens in at Hope College, and then mostly included in the organismal biology. And some others of the have courses focused on plants and human affairs, or plants and civilization. And if you look at the upper level courses in liberal arts colleges, and these are mostly kind of relevant to ecology or conservation biology, a little bit about focusing on plants a little bit more. Well, we actually do have some students in liberal arts colleges that are interested in plants. So that means that we do actually have hope at liberal arts colleges. And so that means that in liberal arts colleges, plant scientists should really work hard and to do a good job of educating students that are really interested. And make sure and they are offered with high quality. That means that we need to do research now, so we need, of course, you know, have communications with other universities as well, and having a critical mass, not within the college, but throughout other colleges as well. And also, another really important thing I feel is that since a lot of students are gonna be pre-med, and we need to help them see the connections or build the connections between medicine, health-related area, and botany or plant biology. And so through courses like that, human health and nutrition, and being plant-centered and human health and environment as well. Well, and also what we need to do is we need to also work with faculty members from other departments, and for example, we can co-teach some courses like ethnobotany across departments and focus on modern medicine and plants. And also we want students to see other activities in other universities by inviting researchers from other places to come to talk about plants and human affairs. And of course, we want also develop education, general education seminars, focusing on some plants that we call them flagship plants, like related to opioid epidemics that we have now. And of course, there are many other possibilities by developing health-related courses, which are listed here. One of them is really fascinating, is that we want to probably dip into the relationship of plants and neuroscience. And there is actually now people discussing plant neurobiology, and which is actually a fascinating connection between plants and health and medicine. But to summarize, I feel that especially in liberal arts colleges, and we need to, since we don't have a lot of a huge critical mass of people working on plant biology, and we need to think about offering interdisciplinary health-related courses involving faculty members from different departments. And so that might be the most practical and effective way to attract students, and also, of course, to improve you know, the breadth and depth of botanical education in liberal arts colleges. And I really would love to hear what you have to say about other opportunities for increasing, improving botanical education. Thank you very much.
Okay, we can take a couple of questions while David and Rishna is set up for his talk.
Yeah, definitely. You know, in liberal arts colleges, and we ask our students to take courses in history and take courses in, you know, cultural heritage and things like that. So, you know, one idea might be, well, why don't we also teach students about the history of plant discovery and relating that to history of humans. Right, so that's another venue that that could be actually developed.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.